So by now, you've heard a lot about good habits, like avoid junk food, stick to a schedule, get hip to gratitude, meditate every day, sleep better, daydream more, cozy up to your pals, rest your brain, thrive and survive. Whoa, that's a lot to put on your plate. How about just picking one?
When I changed how much sleep I was getting, it radiated into every other part of my life, into my health, first of all, into my relationships, into how present I was in my life and how much more alert and vibrant and also how much more joyful.
It's called a keystone habit, a single habit that can trigger a positive chain reaction that might just change your life.
We wouldn't survive if we didn't have habits, because if every single choice we made all day long relied on deliberating and using this part of the brain, we would all just be stuck. We wouldn't be able to actually live our normal everyday lives. So our brain is designed to take as much behavior as possible and make it automatic through creating habits.
That's because the decision-making prefrontal area is an energy hog. Relying on older routes in the brain to drive habitual behavior frees up your mental resources.
The good news is, if you're trying to create new good habits, your brain is on your side. You know, it's designed to do that. You just really need to think about how to feed it the right information.
All too often, when we're trying to break a habit, we're feeding our brain the wrong information.
I'm not going to do X is a really bad way to think about our habits, and it has to do with how our brains are wired.
It's called ironic monitoring. It's when trying not to think about something inevitably makes you think about that very thing.
So when you tell someone, don't think about white bears, it turns out that after a while, all they can do is think about white bears. I'm gonna try it, right? I'm gonna try not thinking about white bears. God, that is so hard to do. That is so hard to do because you can think about anything else. You know, you try to think about like a strawberry sundae. You try to think about, you know, Paris, France, and you think about it for a second, and then white bear just comes popping right back in. And honestly, I almost never think about white bears.
How do you make or break a habit successfully? The best way is to be specific.
So we say things like, oh, you know, this year I'm gonna eat better. What does eat better mean? What does eat less mean? Eat less of what? How much less? When am I going to eat less?
Try a simple strategy called implementation intention. It's an if-then way of framing your goals.
It's taking that specific action you want to engage in and adding the where and when to it.
For instance, if it's 8 o'clock, then I'll go for a jog.
What it does is it links the if and the then part together. If you activate one, you activate the other. And then it's almost as if there's a part of the brain that's really sort of actively searching for that situation.
Rewards work too, as long as they're immediate. Sure, weight loss may be a reward for jogging every day, but it's way off in the future. A more effective reward? Treat yourself to your favorite smoothie immediately after your workout to reinforce the habit.
For me, it's important to realize that change is not a linear progression. But if we remember that we have the constant ability to course correct, then when we fall off the wagon, we can get right back on.
There's no time like the present. If you want to change your life, then pick a good habit and get started right now.